Yes, I'm recording this right after getting home from work. Who cares? Bite me, cold open.
Spyro's back. Can you take the heat? Rated E for everyone.
PlayStation. It's all about the game. And how you play it. All about control. And if you can take it. All about your debt. And if you can pay it. It's all about pain. And who's gonna make it? I am the game. You don't wanna play me. I am control. No way you can shake me. I am heavy debt. No way you can pay me. I am the pain. And I know you. Look over your shoulder, ready to run like a cleveland bitch from a smoking gun. I am the game, and I make the rules. So move on out, you can die like a fool. Try to figure out what my move's gonna be. Come on over, sucker, why don't you ask me? Don't you forget there's a price you can pay.
The year was 2000, the new millennium. And now that everyone had calmed down from that whole Y2K bullshit, we began to eagerly anticipate the next generation of game consoles, consisting of Microsoft's Xbox, the Nintendo GameCube, and the PlayStation 2. But Insomniac was not done with Spyro. We had one more game, that being Year of the Dragon, which coincidentally was released in the actual Year of the Dragon of the Chinese Zodiac.
Coincidence? I think not!
So, let's get on with it, shall we? The Year of the Dragon occurs once every 12 years when the fairies bring a new batch of eggs to the dragon lands. After a hard day of partying, all the dragons and Hunter, who I guess moved in with Spyro between games, have passed out. This allows a girl named Bianca to steal the dragon eggs with the help of these creatures called Rhinox. She ends up looking at the dragons though, after stepping on Hunter's tail, but she and the Rhinox escape and report to their leader, a chunk bitch known only as the Sorceress. According to Zoe the fairy, this is on the other side of the world, a place known as the Forgotten Realms. Since Spyro, Sparks, Hunter, and Zoe are the only ones going to go through the holes the Rhinos dug, off they go. As Spyro goes on his trip, he once again bumps into Moneybags, who's being paid by the Sorceress to keep some critters locked up to keep them from interfering with her goals. These four animal buddies are Sheila the Kangaroo, a flying penguin named Sergeant Bird, Bentley the Yeti, and a secret agent monkey named Agent 9. According to Sheila, the Forgotten Realms used to be the home to the dragons, but about 1,000 years ago, the dragons just disappeared and took all the magic with them, so the Forgotten Realms have slowly been dying. The only inhabitants in the level scatter through the four homeworlds, but we'll get to that in a bit. I think it's implied that the Sorceress had something to do with the dragon eggs disappearing, and at first, Bianca is led to believe that that's why she wants the dragon eggs, but she soon learns the truth. Once the baby dragons hatch from their eggs, the Sorceress will rip their wings off and use them in a potion to help her live forever.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Horrified by this, Bianca decides to betray the Sorceress, starting by helping Hunter out of a trap he fell into while running around the Evening Lake world, and assists Spyro in defeating the Sorceress. It's not the end though, because at this point there are still some eggs to find, but Spyro has to do that mostly on his own since Hunter and Bianca have gone off to have some weird interspecies romance.
He's a cheetah. She's a bunny. You should be trying to disembowel her!
Take a little break. Let's watch the show.
Once Spyro has collected all the eggs, he has to fight the Sorceress again, who somehow survived getting dunked into lava! And this one ends with her getting dunked into acid.
You cursed rat! Look what you've done! I'm melting! Oh, what a world! What a world!
With all the eggs rescued, celebrations can continue, and that is the end of the original trilogy. Insomniac said that they didn't have any more plans for Spyro, saying that it was hard to not get repetitive with a character that didn't have thumbs. Hence, them moving on to do Ratchet and Clank, and then later on, Resistance. After this game, Spyro would go on to do a bunch of other developers, eventually finding a new home with Activision, but we can worry about that another time. We still have this game's mechanics to talk about.
Mechanically speaking, it's exactly the same as the last game. Every move Spyro had in that game, he has in this game. Supercharged ramps and gates have been replaced with supercharged tracks, and yes, those damn egg thieves make use of them. The biggest change this game brings to the formula is the inclusion of six additional playable characters: Sheila, Sergeant Bird, Bentley, Agent 9, Sparks, and Hunter. With the first four, you have to free them from money bags and get to watch them get as much deserved comeuppance.
least.
Sheila has this kick attack and a ground pound, and she also has a double jump. If you jump again and she hits the ground, she'll do a much higher jump, which is needed to get to some otherwise out of reach areas. Sergeant Bird, despite being a penguin, can fly, and his primary attack is these rocket launchers on his wings. He can also pick up bombs and drop them on the Rhinox. Bentley is the biggest and slowest of the bunch in terms of speed. His vernacular is pretty loquacious. Primary attack is his club, which he can also spin to defend himself and deflect projectiles like these snowballs these seals are throwing. And he's also got a boxing minigame. The last of the four you rescue is Agent 9, who serves as the precursor to what Ratchet and Clank will become, being a third-person shooter and all. He can also throw bombs and grenades that come from these vending machines. My favorite level with him is in the fireworks factory, which is one big throwback to Doom.
Hit it!
Once you complete a world, you can go back and talk to Zoe, who's hovering at these signs with sparks painted on them. These lead to Sparks levels, where Sparks just has to get to the end and defeat a mini-boss, and upon completion, he gets a new power-up. The last of the extra playable characters is Hunter, whom you find in the Speedway levels, and his missions involve either shooting down or escaping sheep and flying saucers.
What?
Sheep. In. Flying. Saucers. Most times, though, once you rescue your animal buddies, you can find them in the various levels through these minigame portals. Most of them only last a few minutes and are relatively painless, but this one in Spooky Swamp, where Sheila has to escort two fireflies with bombs to rescue kittens some eggs, can fuck right off! The idiots go in the direction of the rocks and the mushrooms, and since they're carrying live bombs, that means bombs go boom! Fuck this mission!
I think I'm good now. I got a milkshake.
There are other things you can do in the levels as well. Spyro can command vehicles from time to time, like a tank, speedboat, and flying saucer, but he can also go visit a couple of skate parks that Hunter finds. Because what was all the rage at the time but extreme sports? He can also get into the skateboard and snowboard races throughout the game, and let me just say, fuck the snowboard race against the Yetis. I'll leave it at that. Year of the Dragon is a vast improvement over Ripto's Rage. Despite this game's few shortcomings, it's easily the best in the original trilogy, though the first game will always be my favorite. The egg hunt, the levels, the additional characters, and even some of the boss fights, minus Spike, he can suck a dick, are great fun, so give it a shot before the Reunited Trilogy comes out this September.
Thus ends the original Spyro Trilogy on the PlayStation 1. Will I ever get to end with Dragonfly or the Legend of Spyro series? I also don't know what's next on the list. Let's see here. I thought I was supposed to do The Legend of Dragoon next. Who changed this? Well, Legend of Dragoon is a pretty fucking long game, so maybe it's better that I do Medieval next. So, next time, yeah, we're going to take a look at Medieval on the PS1 and its 2005 remake on the PlayStation Portable, Medieval Resurrection. I'll see you then.
There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over.
closer. They can say what they want now. Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us. They can say what they want now.
One more thing.
Your heart out, Tony Hawk.